Imran on the program this evening. Donations to the Aam Aadmi Party online show a big drop since the dharna fiasco. Is the AAP losing its sheen, or will its dharna-style politics help it in the Lok Sabha polls? Also this evening, the horrific story of the tribal girl allegedly gang-raped after orders by village panchayat. Is there a complete lack of political will to take on these village courts? That's a little later in the show, but first, the AAP's top decision-making body, its Political Affairs Committee, is currently meeting in the national capital to decide the future of its controversial law minister, Somnath Bharti. There have been increasing calls for Mr. Bharti's resignation over his controversial raid against African women, which ultimately led to Arvind Kejriwal's dharna. But has the controversy hit the AAP where it hurts? Online donations for the party have gone down over the last few days.
Though these scenes were common on news television screens and on the front pages of newspapers, not all of it was good press. Even among supporters, there were voices against the party, many questioning such tactics now that the party is in power.
इससे पहले भी कितने कैसे ऐसे आए हैं जब लोग थाने में रिपोर्ट करने गए नहीं हुआ लेकिन वो कोर्ट से ऑर्डर लाए
आप कह रहे हैं कोर्ट जाना चाहिए
बिल्कुल जाना चाहिए बजाय इसके कि इतना बड़ा प्रोटेस्ट करके कितने हजारों आदमी जो आज सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉय परेशान हो रहे
While the party boasts about its swelling ranks 50 lakh now there are signs that enthusiasm for the new kid on the block could be waning after the recent controversies On 1st January, the party got more than 40 lakh rupees. In the past few days, donations have come down and today's collection was a little over 4 lakh rupees. The party, though, does not feel their support base is dwindling. The Congress feels otherwise.
So, if you haven't given any attention to us, we have been running some campaigns every time. So, in the past 20 days, we haven't run any campaign. The donations were coming from us, they were coming from us.
आपके सपोर्टर्स को लग रहा है कि हर बार ये धरना थोड़ा यू नो दे फीलिंग डिसिल्यूजन्ड व्हाट वुड यू से
मैं उल्टा सोच रहा हूँ हमारे सपोर्टर को लग रहा था कि ये वोट चुनाव सरकार ज्यादा हो गया था और जो संघर्ष है वो थोड़ा पीछे चला गया था देश भर में बहुत उत्साह है
टेक दिल्ली यू हैव अ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ऑफ वन पार्टी यू हैव अ स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ अनदर पार्टी व्हिच आई डोंट नो इफ दे हैव अनरैवल्ड मोर इन द लास्ट कपल ऑफ डेज
With new controversies emerging and the old ones haunting them, political experts say AAP should tread carefully. The party's fall could be as quick as their rise. Reporting from New Delhi, Anshul Vora, NDTV.
So is the Aam Aadmi Party losing its sheen? That's what we're talking about this evening, as we said, as the party's top leadership meets to decide on Somnath Bharti's future. The big question also is whether Mr. Bharti needs to step down and set or at least give the Aam Aadmi Party a high moral ground on this issue. We have senior lawyer and activist Madhu Mehra joining us here in the studio. The BJP's new spokesperson, Mr. Aman Sinha, is here in the studio with us as well. Arun Bhatia, former IAS officer, joins us tonight from Pune. We'll be shortly joined by representatives of the Congress and AAP. In just a bit. Let me take that to Mr. Bhatia first. Mr. Bhatia, do you believe, firstly, in Mr. Somnath Bharti's case, that the only way the Aam Aadmi Party can really take a high moral ground, if there is one left to take at this point, is for him to step aside, at least until the inquiry is over?
I think, ma'am, the right thing over there to do is that Kejriwal should come forward. Either he should ask his minister to resign, or if he thinks he is innocent, then he should publicly defend him. The Times Now channel has over and over said, and it's very saddening for us, that the Aam Aadmi Party doesn't send its spokesman to that channel. We can't run away from this. And Kejriwal must either defend him in public or let him step down, let him resign. The resignation of a minister is not such a big thing. Don't make a prestige issue out of that. It will show what the party is all about. You will come out stronger. But we not want to know the facts. Was he wrong? How wrong was he? Today what we know is the man's values were all... Ori, all warp. He can't treat women like this, and it's a disgrace. So he should step down. But if Kejriwal feels no, there is another side to it, the facts are wrong, he must come on the media himself and either defend this guy or ask him to resign. But the issue must be resolved.
Okay, interesting.
You know, it's the party that is important, it's the movement that's important, not individuals. X is right, wrong, so-and-so is wrong. We can't let the party, the movement, the ideology take a hit because of this. As far as the donations are concerned, it's, you know, if there's an election tomorrow, they get more donations, damage control can be done.
I will come to that in just a moment, but I think you make a very good point that it shouldn't become a prestige issue about an individual when there is such a lot of other important ideas that the AAP stands for. Let me take that to Professor Anand Kumar, who is the spokesperson of the Aam Aadmi Party, who joins us tonight. Professor Kumar, there have been other voices like Mr. Bhatia's who are members of your party who also believe that Mr. Bharti should step aside until the inquiry is over.
No, I'm not
I believe there is an increasing churning within the AAP on this issue as well, that maybe he should step down. Do you believe he should?
Well, you know, Mr. Bhatia is one of our icons for cleanliness in public life and probity in places of responsibility. What he suggests is already there within our frame of discussions. We already have subjected ourselves to an inquiry by Lieutenant Governor's judicial officer, and as soon as the report comes, we'll honor it and we will try to be as open and as clean as possible. Secondly, we don't have any prestige issue. Prestige of India, prestige of Indian Constitution, prestige of Indian state and prestige of Government of Delhi is uppermost in our consideration. You remember that we dropped 3 candidates during the election for Delhi Vidhan Sabha when they were found to be giving us half-truth information. So for us, no individual is above the considerations of common cause, and we are going to pursue the path of truth.
In that case, sir, why doesn't Mr. Bharti just step aside till the inquiry is on? You know, the SHO has been asked to go on leave. Based on just that principle, why shouldn't Mr. Bharti also say, look, I'm not going to do my ministerial work. I will step aside until my name is cleared. If he's confident his name is cleared, he will be back.
I hope that this message goes to him as well, because this is an individual choice. And your message is loud and clear.
Okay, so you do believe that if it was you in his place, you would have listened to your conscience and done that. You would have stepped aside. You believe that's what he needs to do.
Well, and that's something which could have happened with me, provided it was me there. I'm not there. So, you know, it varies from person to person. Maybe he feels that there is already a media trial and his name is maligned forever, and he needs a chance to put this record straight, because it all happened, which was recorded in some kind of a video thing, and the police was present. But if the details are mixed up and there is a grey area, it has to be investigated as thoroughly as possible.
Okay, Mr. Sinha, is it fair to blame the media though for this? Is this a media trial? It's interesting, because very often we are accused by the BJP of focusing too much on the AAP. The AAP feels that the media has turned hostile and turned against it, especially in the course of this week. Is this a media problem or the AAP's problem?
No, absolutely, Nidhi, you're right. This is AAP's problem. I think AAP has realized that it is legally untenable now for the law minister to continue. And I think, you know, in some time, you know, they might ask him to resign. But please look at the conduct of this minister, Nidhi. He wants judiciary to report to the executive. He goes on, you know, exposing the name of, you know, the Danish woman who was gang raped. He goes and threatens women and police officers. I mean, and he, you know, he uses such foul language against the icons of this country who have contributed many times much more than what he has, you know, ever imagined that he would do in his life. And still AAP is carrying on with him. And up till just 2 hours back, they were just hell-bent on defending him. You know, this whole drama in the national capital was carried out, and the national capital was at ransom only because they wanted to defend the law minister. And, you know, this put the Republic Day celebrations also, you know, they threatened the Republic Day celebrations also. So I think they have now realized that it has become absolutely untenable for the law minister to continue, and therefore they might ask for his resignation.
Okay, so that is something that is a buzz that's going around tonight. Whether Mr. Bharti is actually asked to do that is something we'll have to wait and see.
Absolutely.
In terms of the outcome of that meeting. But Madhu Mehra, as an activist and as a lawyer, you know, across, you know, party lines, across groups, we've seen a number of women's groups write to Arvind Kejriwal on this, saying that, you know, Mr. Somnath Bharti needs to go. What would you say to the AAP this evening?
You know, there are two things here I'd like to ask. One is, of course, that they have this participatory style of politics, which is open and accessible, and that has been their USP. That is what has attracted a lot of people to them. Now, to talk to people about everything, the whole issue of referendum, going to the mohalla, it's all very well, but we know this entity called people is not undifferentiated. This people, this group of people has hierarchies along the lines of class, caste, religion, minority status, and so on. So which people are you going to be listening to? And when you do listen to all these voices that come to you, as what happened in Kirki, how do you filter those voices? What is the value or the standard through which you analyze and assess the validity of those voices? Because if it's just going to be the dominant voice that AAP is going to be listening to and acting upon, then my question is, where is women's rights in all this? We don't, what we are seeing, in the last week being said is a lot about protecting women, but where is women's rights, women's liberties, women's freedoms in all this? That has been a big casualty. So my two questions is, you have a process that seems to be democratic on the face of it, but where is that value system? That's not clear. Is it the constitution or is it majoritarianism?
But let me just ask you, and I'll tell you this from people, if you speak to people from Malviya Nagar today, there was somebody who came up to me today very agitated and angry, and he said, I support what Somnath Bharti did. Do you know how much crime there is in where I live in Malviya Nagar? He was angry, he was agitated. He said the cops don't do anything, they don't act, we're frustrated, my house was burgled. You know, you guys don't realize the reality. On the ground, for them, the ends justify the means, in a sense. How do you answer that constituency?
I'm sure that, you know, there are people who support that. There is, of course, a constituency that he pandered to. But there are other groups within that same area which are not that majoritarian, which are sort of the African community that is living there. Did he go and consult with them? Did he go and ask with them if there was a police complaint that was not being acted upon? Could they not have agitated outside the police station if this is just agitational politics? What was the reason for the chief minister to make that subject a big agenda and have the whole party
a prestige issue, in a sense? Yes. Professor Anand Kumar answer that, and I'll come to Mr. Sin after that. Yes, Professor Kumar.
No, it was a procedural crisis where ordinary people failed to get attention of the police for registering FIR. It got verified when it came to the top level, that is when the ministers are useless to move and persuade police officers. A woman came with a complaint of harassment. Police did not register FIR. She went to the minister, Raki Birlan. Minister asked, they did not do anything, and the woman was burnt. Today she is fighting for her life, but she is out of our focus. She is also a woman. And in case of Sri Somnath Bharti, he got a letter from Resident Welfare Association. There was nothing like majoritarianism. There was only common cause. We want to live in places where there is law and order, where there is no scope for suspicious activities. And it has nothing to do with any nationality, any race. They could be very well, Indians engaged in drug peddling, in, flesh trade. And Delhi is growing as a hub for these activities,
unfortunately. Mr. Bhardi didn't seem to think it was that way, because he said,
so
people told me
to
Nigerians that are indulging in a sex and drug racket here. So he was very clear where he thought that this was going. But the question, though, has this hurt your party, Professor Anand Kumar? That's the question. Mr. Sinha, I'll take that to you. As much as the BJP and the Congress would like to think that this has hurt the AAP and that the AAP has lost its sheen, in a sense, are you all jumping the gun and gloating as the mainstream parties? Let me ask the BJP first, sir. I'll come to you. Let me get everyone's view.
Absolutely not, Nidhi. If you see
is
the law...
Is there a danger? You're underestimating them still.
No, but this country, we have to decide whether we have to run by rule of law, rule of justice, courts and our constitution, or there will be a mobocracy and all the elected representatives and ministers will go out on a night vigil and start raiding homes and calling out women. Do we want that kind of a democracy? Supreme Court has specifically prohibited that there could be no arrest of a woman after sunset and before sunrise. There is a specific provision in CRPC section 46, which says 46.4, which says that a woman cannot be arrested, in midnight after sunset. And if at all in exceptional circumstances it has to be, it can only be by, an order of a first-class magistrate. Now, in this case, Mr. Bharti not only, raids the homes, he wants, police also to, work according to his whims and fancies. This is the same party which till some time back was saying that investigative agencies should have independence and autonomy in working. They shouldn't go by whims and fancies of ministers and political representatives.
That is the irony.
And now they have taken an absolute somersault and they say that no, they should work in case of AAP ministers.
But I'm saying
they should work right in according
to what they say. It's the question I asked Madhu, that there are people on the ground that you talk to who will in a sense support this vigilantism because they are fed up of the system. There are processes in place. There is a constitution. There are institutions in this country. But a lot of people feel, so what? Kaam nahi hota hai. If this is the way you're going to get the cops to work, then they're supportive. I'm saying that, you know, is it dangerous for us to underestimate the influence that the AAP could have?
It's a dangerous precedent, Nidhi. You have pointed out the right thing. Because, you know, please tell me, did Mr. Bharti communicate to police commissioner or DCP that there is such a problem? Did he collect any evidence that this is what was happening? And his party is full of legal luminaries. Did anyone approach court under Section 156 to get a criminal complaint registered? No. You go with, you know, OB vans and media, in media scrutiny, you know, and in media limelight, you want that, you know, your just your symbolism or, and your message should go. You don't want to deliver anything in terms of substance to the people there. You just want to score political brownie points. And that is the charge that we have been making, that, you know, this is all a fixed match between Congress and Aam Aadmi Party. And, you know, the only goal, objective is to, you know, split the anti-incumbency vote and stop the BJP and Narendra Modi from coming to power.
Let me